Okay, people, welcome to another episode of Podcasting. Today I have a special guest from Mallorca. So we don't know English both. Two gringos, a lot of alcohol. It will be fun. Mike, brother, welcome to Podcasting.
Hello, hello. Happy to be here. It's back nice, in Stockholm.
Nice to meet you after how much? Two years almost.
No, yeah? One year. One year.
Yes. How are you, brother?
Very good, very good. Very cold.
Very cold from Mexico to Stockholm.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fucked up, man.
It's fucked up. And I come here and they have restrictions again.
Yeah. Shit.
But very happy to be back.
So, cheers, salud, brother. Nice to meet you
again. Nice to meet you again. It's cold, they say here.
Yeah, it's cold.
Okay, Mike.
No zdrovje. Can you tell me a little bit more about yourself?
Well, I'm Mike. I'm from Mallorca, Spain. Been living there most of my life. And yeah, I played basketball when I was young. And then I started drawing in the school, in the tables and everything. And that got me into a job in the tattoo shop with henna tattoos for tourists. And then I wanted to learn more and ended up like tattoo artist. Yeah, nice.
How would you describe what you do?
What I do, well, basically I paint people. They are happy most of the times. You cannot please everybody.
Yeah,
they are happy and I like it. And that made me travel, meet nice people around the world.
Yeah, that's
and
true.
And this is really nice. Yes.
We can say we go on a job to put people in pain and they give you money for that and enjoy.
Yeah, they pay you to hurt them and then they are happy. They even tip you sometimes when you are very lucky. tip you for hurt them. What is that?
The best job ever.
Yeah, can't complain.
Tell me, how did you get started with tattoo?
Yeah, like I said before, I started like painting in the school, then I got the job in the shop for henna tattoo, and I was doing all the designs, and then I looked the artist doing the job and it's like, I want to do this too. And then I start looking a lot, drawing a lot, because I wanted to do realistic, so I was drawing a lot of portraits. I have like album like this thick of girls portraits mostly. I'm sorry. If you are a girl, then you are more lucky. If you're a guy, one day I will draw guys too. But yeah. C'est la vie.
Can you remember the first tattoo you ever did?
First tattoo. I got some machines, very cheap. The first machines you get, very cheap. And I said to my father, yeah, I'm ready. I watched the guys do it in the shop. And my father was my first tattoo. And I did a tattoo after that for 3 months. Or 4 months until I thought I was ready, but I was a little bit more ready. Yeah.
First time I make some tree of life and some lettering, but it's still good.
Yeah, no, my tattoo in my father is cover up. Yeah.
What do you like about this job?
Mostly like you can create something that will last forever. That's also a pressure. But also that lets me travel around and you are not like slave in a job that you don't like. So if I don't like some country, I just leave and find a new one. And that's how we live.
Yeah, that's true. But it's nice, you know, because you travel all the time. You meet new people, you know, you learn new stuff, almost every day.
Yeah, that's...
And it gives you freedom, you know.
Yeah, that's a job that gives you a lot of freedom. The only thing is like, it's very tough to learn it.
Yeah.
But
it takes time.
Yeah. But then when you learn it, it's good.
Can you describe style of tattoos that you did?
Well, I am from Mallorca. So there what you do a lot is walk in. So you have to have a really straight line and specialize in that. But my favorite style is realistic. And big piece realistic. Black and gray mostly. I don't do color too much. Sometimes I do, but I'm starting just to specialize in black and gray, realistic. Yeah,
but in Mallorca.
But in Mallorca, it's like
tattoos.
What?
Pinterest tattoos.
Most likely, yeah. You have Pinterest is your best friend nowadays.
Yeah. That's a fashion now.
I try not to put crowns on lions, if you ask me.
But I put. Don't worry.
That's my job. So I'm sorry, guys, if you see this. You can make a lion, but don't put a crown.
Or blue eyes.
Yeah. Yellow eyes look so good. And it's like they look in the savannah. Yellow, like gold color. They are a color. In tiger, maybe you can put a little bit, but not on lions.
Tell me, what's your favorite piece and why?
My favorite piece, it will be like my favorite customer also. I think I met him 7 years ago, and I made his full back, and that's one of my favorite. And he also have now the full arm, and the neck now I made on him is my favorite piece, because he come to me, he have to wait. I don't have like, I don't know. I don't have Harris. He say whenever you're ready, you tattoo me, and then he say I want this, and he let me do whatever I want. And yeah, and if I am tired in 4 hours, I tell him, okay, come next week. And then it's like, and then I do 8 hours, maybe 12. And I don't know, I don't count the time. And it's like, you paint on paper. He sit down, he don't move.
Like he's sitting like a rock.
Like he don't move. I tattoo on he on the neck. And I have to tell him, don't worry, we can take a break, because he don't want to tell nothing. And I was putting black, solid black on here. And he don't say nothing. And the position, you're in the table like this. Like this. No, you know, when you have somebody that give you freedom, then it's your favorite piece.
Yeah. But when we speak about clients, what you think? Is it hard to find a client who will give you freedom?
In that, it's like selling a car. So you have to specialize in talking, trying to, like... He have an idea, try to go more in your style, because at the end it will look better. But it's about selling. But it's very difficult. They want the tattoos that they see on other people. And that's why mostly on the streets, if you go around, most of people, they have the same 100 tattoos and maybe 50. If you go, it's like, I did these tattoos maybe 2 times. He did them 2 times. The other artist did 2 times. So then it's like, we all did them, so... But we sometimes don't have a choice, because I show them sometimes 2 tattoos, and then it's, okay, choose. And they choose the same one from Pinterest that you cannot do nothing. You
just copy-paste.
Yeah.
So much.
And the problem with that on lions and tigers is this, that we only have 20 lion pictures. So, and we have done more than 20 lion tattoos. That we don't post them doesn't mean we don't do them.
Yeah, that's true.
And I posted the last week something about it, that we don't post them. It doesn't mean we don't do it. And at the end, we need to work too. So we do the same lion twice. Yeah. So that's why we have this stereotype about lions.
Yeah.
Or tiger.
Yeah. Tell me, what is the most challenging about what you do?
Challenging? I don't know. You have to be there every day, in your bad days and in your good days. You have to be there. And we are humans. So, like, you have all the jobs that you don't have a good day. You fuck up, like, you're a chef, you fuck up the food. The customer will complain, but if I fuck up the piece, man, it's going to be on this guy forever.
Yeah. Every day is challenging.
Yeah, we have the pressure. And challenging, it's depends. Sometimes you have, like, burned skin. Or some people, they cut their skin.
Yeah, scars. And
Or sometimes it's even the talking with the customers, that like when you have darker skin, you have to contrast a lot more. But they want the same tattoo than in the lighter skin.
Yeah.
You can do only black.
Yeah.
Medium if you can use.
Yeah.
And then a little bit white, and it's going to look like beige.
Yeah, that's true.
That also matters, the skin tone. It's a job that it will change every day, like make necks, ribs, then you put the stencil, eat the forms, like, and then you have to figure out how to make it that it doesn't deform. like when you make faces in the body, it's, if you put it here, it have to be perfect. If not, it would look like ET.
Yeah, you must know the things also, and also, you know, like you say, you have different skin, so you have sometimes old skin, you know, so dry skin, so every day is a challenge.
Yeah,
for two artists.
And then it's this, when you know more, is that you go with more, like, you know what to do, but it's still, you cannot run because you have to take your time. But then you know how to do it, so you think you can do faster, but you should not, because then you will fuck up.
Do you think that you learn something new every day in your job?
Yeah, it's like you learn something new from the good people, from the bad people. So it's like, but you learn from yourself also what to do if you did it wrong. Every piece, like, you change slightly a little bit, but you learn a little bit, like, for it. Okay, this, I shouldn't have done it so black, or this, when it will heal, it's going to stay too white. So
From tattoo to next tattoo, you grow.
You
see your mistakes and you improve.
Why it's like every day, like, if you look your work from 2 months, and it's crazy because for me, when I want to work on big project, this is important. I don't want to let too much time because my style change, because it works with your personality.
Yes.
And then I shade one way, and if you come 2 months later, I don't shade this way. I work with the feeling, like, and some people, they book the sleeve. I know it's hard to pay for once, but when, if you do it faster, then it look better because it's going to be all look like the same. When you want to create something personal, if you want to copy paste, you can do it and then it will look good.
But I say same thing, you know, in podcast, even from bad tattoo artists, you can learn something, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Like from bad, you look and then you are like, okay, that is not good. I should not do this.
Yeah.
And then from good, and you learn how to be better and better.
Yeah.
For example, like, I know some famous artists like Steve Butcher, Yomiko, and so, and you learn the best and the best, but then I show them, like, there is a stupid app, how to make the stencil. It's a stencil maker on Google. And I told them about this app, and they know a lot, like, but it's like somebody like me, that I'm nothing next to them in the tattoo industry, I teach them something. Even if it's little, like, and they are like top, but you learn everything from the good and from the bad, let's say, or a medium.
That's true. What do you think about tattoo seminars?
Tattoo seminars, well, they steal the money many times. If you're not prepared, it's a waste of money too. But then there is also good ones. I've been to seminars. When I started, I was going to more seminars. So I've been with Core Lopez, that it didn't help me too much because it helped basically how to Photoshop the tattoo.
Really?
And then you have to take 2 sessions for the piece like this. And it's true, like, you can make it much better, but then it doesn't work. And then you have some videos, they work. And also, for example, I went with Boris Tattoo. I went to Austria, and this was one of the best seminars because you tattoo it there and then he correct you.
Yeah.
So he come, and then it's like, he said in the application, don't come if you are learning. And some people went if they are learning, and he's not there for teach him how to shade. He's teach you how to make this from the eye to make it look good. Also, for example, I went to multi-seminar in Las Vegas, and this was really good because it was only 2 hours per person, and they put you the key from, like, for example, somebody teach about the composition. Then somebody teach about how the color contrast work when it's healed, because everybody know how to tattoo, but they don't. Then when it's healed, they look like shit. Black and gray or color, if you don't contrast, you can make a perfect photo and it look like shit. For example, Carlos Torres was like, he didn't talk about anything. He talked about how he make design. He said, I'm not going to talk to you about tattoo. You're not going to know anything about the needles because it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I change all the time.
That is also techniques.
Yeah, say, and it's like I change all the time. But for example, Carlos Torres is, when he book a tattoo, he come to talk to him. He pays sometimes, many times, a model. He put them these Victorian clothes that you see, or he put them the clothes. He made the photo shooting, and then he prepared everything like that. And then he's basing the tattoo designs on like how the Japanese works. So he learned with the Japanese how to make with the muscles. So it's always like flow.
To flow.
So he worked kind of with how they paint the Japanese waves. That's how you're going to see the filigrane that he paints is following the same style.
Yeah.
Yep.
But seminars is good, you know.
It's good to specialize.
Yes.
But it's not good if you want to learn which needle do you use. It doesn't fucking matter. Like,
what makes a good artist?
What makes a good artist? Well, many things. I mean, some people don't have the skills, but they put all they can and they know what are their limits. So what they do is going to be good. Then you have people that is fucking talented, but they don't use their potential because they are just lazy and they want to finish the tattoo in 4 hours. Yeah. So I would say the what makes a good artist is like have the patience and dedication to create something that will last forever. I would say also like, yeah, it's like people want to fly and you have to start from zero. When I learned, it was easier, mostly because, like, when I was learning, they put me to learn with the tribal tattoos, like, you know, the spikes, like, that they were in the 90s famous, Chinese letters, like, Gothic letters, like, because if the line is not perfect, then you correct it to the side. But right now, when you have to learn with small tattoos, they want the fine line, and also it's difficult to learn tattoo nowadays. If I look my job from 4 years ago, I will call all my customers to come back for a touch up from 4 years ago, and I've been tattooing for 7 years, so that makes like more than 500 tattoos or 600 tattoos that I will touch up if I will have a chance. So people cannot fly without half a process.
Yeah, but that is also good because you see your progress.
Yeah,
you
know, no,
when
I mean
when you look your work. Like I'm never satisfied with my work, you know.
No, yeah.
Even when I make tattoos and I come after job home and I look, this is shit, man. Why I do this, you know? And then in the morning, when I wake up, drink coffee, and I look again, I say, okay, this is not bad, you know. And then I look for me, saying, oh, this is good, you know, it's not
like,
so bad.
I zoom it like that, so I put like this detail from the tattoo on an iPad like this, looking for a fucking mistake. I mean, we are not robots. These look good.
Yes.
That's what makes also good artists, but that's also for bad for us because we cannot sleep good. That is art. At the end, we are not fucking robot machines. We don't print pictures. We create something.
Yeah. But that is also good, you know, because you look for your mistake and you improve with new tattoo, you know.
You know how to contrast and every time you. That what makes a good artist, I think. Like the.
Yes.
Learn from your mistakes, and to me, like, one of the guys who changed more my tattoo career, he told me, you fucking suck, quit. And he told me this, but he then, instead of just say that, he teach me how to correct it too. Yeah. So it's like, who critic to you also, to help you, that, give you a lot.
Yeah. You're also a tattoo collector. Can you tell me more about that?
Yeah, I started, if I'm not wrong, 2016, with David Garcia. I saw Constellation on the Instagram. By the time, David Garcia is like designer. He worked with Zulen. Like right now, he's not tattooing because he had some health problems. But he's a really, really good illustrator. And I started there. And that was in May 2016, if I'm not wrong. And then on the same September, I saw Jack Connolly. He put cancellation for the tattoo. And I went to Barcelona and I take this piece. I don't know if the camera can see. And I did that. and they invite me to go dinner with them later. And that night I become like quite friend with Steve Butcher. And since then I started like collecting the Nets. The year passed, like, yeah, this, I went to Paris, I didn't get tattooed, but the next one, I went to Paris with Steve Butcher, 2017 or 2018, I don't know exactly, and we won the best of the show with Michael Jordan. I don't know if they can see, it's hairy, but yeah, we won the best of the show.
It's perfect, man.
Yeah, and I don't know, and then you kind of become friends, and I go to conventions to hang out, and it's really nice, and later... The same winter that I won with Steve Butcher, I went to the States, not to work, just to travel. And then I met Levgen in the Washington Tattoo Convention. And talking with him there, he told me in America the prices were much more expensive. That come to meet him in Poland and I would save some money and it would be the same quality. And he didn't have appointment either. So then I got this one by Levgen. He now works with Sivak in New York City.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, really good. It's half four years old. Totally perfect heel. And, yeah, then I got the... First, I got this one, sorry. I was in London Tattoo Convention, not doing nothing, just drinking like a motherfucker, like I always do. I went to say hi to the artist, and I saw Benjamin Laukis free... I have cancellation, I have free. And talk to him, he's like, okay, let's do something. And yeah, we ended up doing this. I was an asshole this day because it was really hard to design.
Yeah.
You know, I wanted a burning church in the hand. I ended up with a skull, but I wanted one of these girls of him burning. And I had my iPad too, so I had some savings. And I give him pictures. He have this his collection of skulls. And we ended up like that. And from a cancellation, is the best of the show. It won too. So I have best of the show from Paris and from London. And I had to save a space for Levgen to work. That he was like, okay, he take a little bit of my space. But, because I had the booking with him before. But, you know, when you have Benjamin Laukis in front of you, available and motivated, you had to go.
Yeah. Yeah.
He works really quick and
I think
but it's really
it
good.
Feels
like
so good, man.
All my tattoos, I didn't get tattoos for fucking 4 years.
You come from the beach.
Yeah. I come right now from Mexico and it's still
perfect, man.
But I take care. When you have good tattoos, please customers, if you see this, plus 50 protection, no sun.
Yeah.
If you want to age good, that's also like matter. When you are 40, if the sun doesn't hit too much your skin, so if you protect your skin, you won't have stretch marks and you will have a healthier skin. So use sun cream. I know it's not pretty to be fucking pale like me, but when you have this face, you can be pale too. You don't need to be tan to be pretty. Yeah, just this is very important. Like, protect your skin. And if you burn the tattoos, the skin, the ink is going to get more light. Even the black color, if the sun hits the black color, it's going to get opaque. So, yeah, very important to heal your tattoos.
But, man, you see, that is so nice memories to say, you know.
Yeah, it was, like, fucking amazing for me to be there. And I don't know, when I talk to them, like, that's a mistake. So... If you stop them in the conventions, that's something nobody talk about it. It's not that they are rude. Just think about it. In the tattoo convention, they have like 5,000 people going to watch. And everybody asks the same questions. And imagine you are, most of us that you will be watching are tattoo artists or you have been tattooed. So if you are there and they ask you, which needle do you use 20 times? And you are on your 10-minute break and you are making a 13-hour piece that you want to put in the contest to try to win something. And they stop you when you are going to pee or just get a beer or you disconnect. Sometimes I leave my customer in the chair and I'm going out of the shop or I go for a walk because I like to disconnect my 10 minutes and keep working.
Yeah.
And then they stop you. It's not that they are rude. It's what they want to disconnect. So this is something that I was also maybe thinking a bit that they were rude, but I never met them in person. I just heard that. Of course, there is some people that I met personally and they are assholes, but most of the tattoo artists are nice. Like, I mean, there is good people and bad people, but if they don't talk to you when they are there, it's because, they want to disconnect mostly.
Yeah. But when we speak about that, what you think about tattoo convention?
Well, tattoo convention, there is good ones and bad ones. Like, for example, London, sadly, it finished. I hope somebody take it back.
But it's
really, really, really nice. And the vibe that you live there, like, I don't go to tattoo these conventions. I wish I could, but it's, like, so hard to get in. Like, you have the top and wait either 5 years list that you never pass it, or just be top and then you don't get to wait. And London, Paris, like, is so amazing. It was ink and iron. Like, it's a vibe that you live there and that you see, you meet, and you see what is possible to do in the world that we just see in the pictures, but in real life, it looks most of the times better.
Yeah. But conventions is also a good opportunity to improve your work.
To
meet good tattoo artists, to catch some tricks and tips, you know.
Yeah, you look there, and normally in the conventions, you can also attend to seminar.
Yeah.
That we talked before, like, you don't need 8-hour seminar. You just need to know a little bit from, if this artist is doing your style, then this little trick is going to help you improve.
Yes. That's true. If you know what to catch with eye, you will learn something.
Yeah. The only problem is this, that they don't teach you too much there, because they just work. Most of the good ones, they only work 2 days, and the third day you're going to see them drunk. Because, like, I go there just on holiday. I work fucking hard on summer, and the conventions are at the end of the summer. So this is my days. Like, I don't even open my phone. They cannot call me from job, and they know it, because I get fucking angry when I disconnection.
But look, if you go on convention and you work 3 days in a row, you will see nothing. You will not meet colleagues, you know, and stuff like that. You will be.
That's why they only want to work 2 days, and then Sundays don't go to the convention, because half of the good artists, they don't want to work. Yeah. Like, they are like, okay, they go there to meet their friends. They don't go to work. And basically, they can kind of just pay the convention with the tattoos, because you have to pay hotel, flight, booth, and everything. So that costs money too.
Tell me, what is the strangest tattoo you have ever done?
Well, strangest, we have, like, I live in Mallorca, and we have a lot of strange tattoos. But I don't tattoo drunk people, so I get to avoid. And sometimes when it's so bad, we just don't do it. So maybe the typical man, like, shaving the hair or here, like, with the machine, or some emojis, or like, I don't know, they ask you to paint, like, some stick man doing things, and
I speak in podcast. I can't remember with who I speak, but I tell them about that guy you work with me, who passed away 2 times when I just only shave his hand. You remember that guy?
Yeah. Sometimes people get nervous and they pass out before. Yeah.
2 times, man. Only when I shave his hand. But I didn't finish that story. You remember? Tomorrow.
I was tattooing his.
The same guy come in shop and tell me, man, you are so good artist, but look, my tattoo is gone. And I look, man, and I look, you know, it's nothing. Look, he put maybe some makeup on some shit.
Yeah.
No, it's nothing. And you start to laugh, and I say, what is the catch? and he tell me, man, he's my twin brother, you know.
Yeah, I was tattooing the twin the next day.
Exactly same, man. Same face, same clothes, everything same.
And you're like, woo!
What the fuck is, man, you know?
That was crazy.
A nice time, man, in shop. Do you think customer is always right in our job?
Well, sadly, our job is one of the only ones that is not always right. if you have, like, of course, we have to give you the best quality that we can. But we told before the tattoo, then my job is to do it. But I have a style. So if you ask me to make it darker, many times I don't want to do it because I don't think it look good and I want to be happy with my job. Yes,
I understand.
And it's very typical nowadays. It's the other way. They say, no, but I don't want it too dark. But I say to them, before I start my tattoo, I say, okay, look my Instagram. This is how I work this style of tattoo. This is how I do fine line. And I show pictures of fine line. Like what you see me in the internet, I don't believe it heals good, or I cannot do it this way, or this is not my way. So this is how I do it. If you want me to approach the image that you have in mind in this style, I can do it. But then later, don't stop me. And sometimes happen you're in the way. And sometimes they can be right, but it's not always right. Like, you cannot.
Yeah. I understand.
Sometimes, I don't know how to say it, but normally it's about shading. When I shade it, when it's healed, it's lighter. So it's going to always look darker when it's fresh. But when it healed, it will look lighter. Same, it's going to be red many times. And yeah, we have to talk before. And then I'm very strict on that. When we talk about the tattoo before, I approach and you know how I'm going to work, because supposedly you have seen my work. And then if you want to change something and it's possible, we will do it. But sometimes it's not possible. I don't want to do something that I'm not going to be happy with. Or I learned this from a very good friend of mine. He tell me, you are happy with the result. Then you take a picture. That's how you're happy. Then sometimes if you think it's not going to look bad, you do what they ask. But at least you're going to have the picture with the satisfied result. I mean, it's very hard to please everybody. Imagine in the music, if you're going to a concert or just look at album of music from your favorite singer, do you like every single song his album? Yeah. It's like, but you're still buying it or going to their concerts.
But I also think that customers, this is not right.
Yeah,
yeah. In our job, it's not.
Yeah, I mean, it's very difficult to say it, but it's like, or sometimes I gotta say, like, the artist, they show me the picture. I know how much time they take. I know how good or famous they are from the original one. And I can get very close to that, but I need 2 sittings and all that. And then when you say, like, it's how much is 2 sittings, then they say, okay, what you can do for one?
Yeah.
And then because exactly. 2 sittings, then it's 2 sittings. Even for do this, most of, like, these guys that you see hyper-realistic and so, it's 1 sitting and 1 touch-up, 2 sitting.
Yeah. What advice would you offer somebody who considering this career?
Don't start.
No. Quit.
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 Basically, draw a lot. Have a strong drawing portfolio. Check how they tattoo, get ideas, reference, and try to create a drawing style when you have a strong portfolio. Go to shops. They look for apprentice, like, and yeah, YouTube and all this. The problem is that you're going to start with your friends. You're going to fuck up. They will not trust you. Then you will be hard to get a name back again. But if you start in a shop, of course, you're going to be like in the old school. You have to clean, be the receptionist, like, for half year before you start learning. But if you think about it, what can you study nowadays with a good salary that is going to take you only 6 months? So you're going to clean the floor, but you don't have to pay for the course, and you're going to learn. So the best is have strong drawing portfolio and then go try to apply for shops. I didn't do it like that. I wish because then you have, like, some friends have the first tattoos and you wish you had some bodiness to you, correcting you all the time, and I would have cleaned the floor for more time, because nothing you can study right now is going to take you less than 2 years, and you can learn that job in a year if you do it in a proper way.
Yeah.
But first, you have to have a strong drawing portfolio, let's say.
Yeah. Any advice to people who getting the tattoo for the first time?
Yeah, I mean, the first tattoo hurts as much as the last. Probably right now, I have more tattoos And I will be more pussy because I am friend. And they say, okay, let's have a break. But basically, eat good, then sleep good the night before. Drink a lot of water the day before so your skin is hydrated. That also works. Don't be sunburned. That's a big mistake. And basically, go mental prepared. It's going to be painful. If you use numbing cream, I cannot work. I refuse to tattoo with numbing cream because it, like my tattoos with that, they didn't heal good. I hurt too much skin. I cannot control the deep because it's more rough.
Yeah.
So,
it's so hard.
I refuse. I'm sorry if you hear it. I don't tattoo with numbing cream. And it's, I did it two times because I had to, but I don't like it. I get even nervous because you do the line and it feels like I'm cutting the skin. But go with the balls on, mentally prepared, and it's not that hard. I have one customer. He come first tattoo from here to here, 120 kilos, 2 meters. Like he did 2 days in a row, 24 hours.
Yes, like you say, you know, eat good before session. Don't drink like a pills and that shit.
Take a rest, drink water. Yeah.
Don't be hangover before tattooing. Check good for tattoo artist. Look at his work, you know. Think good about what you want.
Yeah.
You know.
I know that you want it. Yeah, so come ready.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's also, you know.
That matters too, because if you are I want to get it, but I don't know. But if you know it, you just sit there. I sit 13 hours color tattoo on this one. I couldn't even walk the next day. I fall from the bed when I wake up. But I just put the balls on and it's like, and we ended up singing and I was like playing like video games, like, but.
Yeah. I'm getting also one tattoo on tattoo convention and we get second place for old school with that tattoo. But also I remember like 200 people going, you know, all the time. So I have a pain, but I don't want to show, you know, because of people. And then I, like you say, I play games and, you know.
Yeah, you try to distract the brain.
Music, you know, but I don't want to make like.
For me, after 11 hours of doing this tattoo, they start playing the concert in the convention, heavy metal. And you are trying to relax. And I'm like. And I put the headphones, and Steve Butcher don't like metal neither. So we both singing hip hop like. Bruh, 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 bruh. He's a really good singer. Yeah. I didn't sound that good, but I tried.
Tell me, do you have any future projects you want to share with us?
Projects? Well, I have 2 shops right now in Mallorca. And for now, I stay there. I want to work more abroad. But at the same time, I want to live life. This time I realized that it's not all about work. It's also about living, traveling, have friends. Like right now, I'm coming here to Sweden and I come mostly to visit. Like I don't focus on the work. And I think with all that happened with the corona and things that happened, made me realize it's not all about money. You have to live too. If you can, don't. Of course, I like the job, but it's better to live too. So the project right now is like, keep the shop, but try to live, let's say.
Yeah, I know that you like so much to travel around the world.
Yeah, I go with my backpack. I book the backpack and I go 2 months, 3 months. But if you know how to do it, then it's like not so expensive.
Tell me, beyond the tattooing, what are you really passionate about?
Yeah, I would say I was playing basketball before, so basketball is...
You met Michael Jordan.
I met Michael Jordan.
And Ice Cube also.
And Ice Cube.
Yes, motherfucker.
Michael Jordan, Ice Cube, among others. And till I was maybe 14, I was quite good and I didn't grow more. And I liked the party and... Then I focus, on the drawing and the tattoo later. And traveling is, I've been traveling also since I'm 18. I get a backpack and I bought a ticket to Russia when I was 18 alone, then to Thailand the same year. And since that, I've been traveling 2-3 months a year with my backpack. Then COVID fucked it up. Then I came to Sweden. And this year I could go Mexico, Guatemala again. So traveling is...
Yeah, you are all over the place, man.
I'm sorry, I love my work, but it's number one and then it will be work.
Yeah, because you gotta leave. Also to have a life.
Yeah, you have...
It's not about job.
You have to try to have a balance. It's really hard. Because at the end, you spend a lot of money traveling, but why you want to have money if I could die in 5 years? Like, that's what made me wake up, that you can die, like, when you are 40. Yeah. Or I imagine right now, I'm 26. If you have a kid in 4 years, if I didn't travel these 4 years, then you have a kid and you cannot travel.
Yeah.
Then it's like, you have to live, basically.
Yeah, what is the life if you have money, but you just go from work home and home work, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And it's like, of course, I like my job.
There is freedom,
At the end, it's a job, too.
Yeah.
So it's the freedom that gives you. It's something you cannot... Yeah, it's basically this. Like, it made me realize, it's like, I have like 5-6 years of freedom, maybe more, who knows? But yeah, it's like, you're growing up, man. Before fucking COVID, I was 24. But yeah, thankfully, I'm back right now in Stockholm and we could do this podcast.
Yes. So, thank you again for this conversation.
Thank you for inviting me.
And nice to see you again. And see you soon with next episode.
I will watch it. I hope you share it.
And subscribe.
And like.